And we're back. And the guy to my left has got a little more white hair than I do, maybe. I don't know. We could be twins up top, couldn't we?
Yeah, I guess so.
Les Steckel is our special guest, ladies and gentlemen, a name from out of the past where the Titans are concerned. Les was the offensive coordinator with Jeff Fisher when the Titans came to town, took them to the Super Bowl. And then Les has just recently retired as the national president for the Fellowship of Christian Athletes. Coach? Always a pleasure.
Yeah, well, likewise. Thanks
good, good to see you. You good look like you're still in playing weight, huh?
Yeah, possibly, but I think one hit and I'd be done.
Well, no, not really. But you know, the first thing I remember about you was seeing you jog. You know, when you guys first came to town and when practice was over, you were out in the shorts. You were just running around, I was out in Bellevue, where the mobile homes were,
sure,
and all this other stuff,
sure,
and you were just out getting it.
I took off running, trying to get away from guys like you in the media.
I know you did, but you didn't get far, did you?
No, I didn't.
You're accustomed to us. You go way back with the media.
Absolutely,
there's no question about that. You know, we could talk a long time about your career, and we will. For people who may not be quite as familiar as I am with it, but if you want to, just kind of give us a little run through of your coaching career, and you can make it as long or short as you want to.
Well, you know, I've been blessed to be married to a woman by the name of Chris.
Yep.
For 44 years, I affectionately call her Preppy, and she survived 11 states, 12 moves, and 13 teams. So
wow.
There's
a lot of love going on where that lady's concerned.
She sometimes, I think, she likes football more than me, but people question me on that statement. But I got started, at the University of Colorado. I came back from Vietnam. I was an infantry officer and then played 2 years on the National Marine Corps team.
Marine Corps.
Yes.
Absolutely. And, once a Marine, always Marine.
Yes. 30 years worth.
Yeah.
And coached at the University of Colorado. Started out as a graduate assistant. For anyone who's young and listening, I got paid $150 a month, slept on a cot with no heat in a garage in Boulder, Colorado for 18 months.
That's your camera over there.
So without a doubt, I want you to know that you have to pay your dues as you get started.
You do.
And from there, we went to the Naval Academy, and then I had a lucky break with the San Francisco 49ers. And from there on to Minnesota, later was head coach, and then on to the Patriots. Was blessed to be Raymond Berry's offensive coach for him. What a wonderful man he is.
With the Patriots, when you guys played the Bears.
We played the Bears in Super Bowl 20. They barely beat us, 46-10.
I know.
And,
Raymond, by the way, is in Murfreesboro.
Yes,
you
he
know
is.
That. Yeah.
Yes, he is. A special man. And after that, then we moved on to the Denver Broncos and the Houston Oilers and then on to Tennessee. And then down to Tampa with Tony Dungy for a while and finished my career in Buffalo, New York.
Well, you know, you've got quite a distinguished career. Anybody that can stay in one profession that long and that many places, you know, you are to be commended, because, you know, it's like anything else that you do in this life. First of all, you should love it, and you and your wife both loved it.
We did.
Even during the hard times, even the times that weren't so good, you know, when you were fired or when you were whatever the case may be,
sure,
and ownership changes, and a lot of things happened to a lot of us, and so you hung in there, and then, but you know, your faith has been predominant, shall I say, throughout most of your life, has it not?
Yeah, my wife Chris and I looked at it as another opportunity to move. We felt like the good Lord was in charge of our personal lives and our marriage and our children. And oftentimes we saw ourselves move because there was something in store for one of our children and never knew it until we got to the next location. So we moved sometimes by choice and sometimes not by choice, but we accepted it each and every time it came up.
And as I said a moment ago, you just retired. How do you compare? You really don't compare being president of the Fellowship of Christian Athletes with say head coaching or coaching. I mean, it's really two different things, right?
It is. The ministry in the NFL, the culture is so different. But what we tried to do when I was asked to lead the ministry for 12 years, it was, first of all, a great blessing. The fun part was my wife and I got to do it together. And we traveled over 200 days a year. We were in 49 states.
Wow.
From Portland, Oregon to Portland, Maine. I tell you, you know, Fargo, North Dakota, Corpus Christi, Texas. We saw Harlem and Honolulu.
We hit all the high spots.
States, yeah. So we really experienced a special experience, and we saw amazing results. You know, I look at it, the ministry's been around 64 years. And so the good Lord's kept it there for that reason. He wants to see athletes and coaches have a chance to share their faith and make a difference in this country. Tom Landry, the famous Hall of Fame coach with the Dallas Cowboys, was probably our most legendary icon, not only in the NFL, but with the Fellowship of Christian Athletes. And to have people like Roger Staubach, and we got young people all across this country involved in a great ministry.
Les and I attend the same church on Sundays, Brentwood Baptist Church. They're on Concord Road at 777 Concord Road. Right. And you've got an event coming up on the 19th of this month that you need to tell people about.
Yeah, I'd like to really share that with you folks. We're doing a men's spring training camp. It's being sponsored by the Fellowship of Christian Athletes and also Brentwood Baptist Church. It's going to be Saturday morning, the 19th of May, from 8 a.m. till 12 noon. The event is at Brentwood Baptist Church. It's going to be held in Hudson Hall. You can register online at brentwoodbaptist.com/men-training-camp. That's brentwoodbaptist.com, men training camp.
We'll try to get that up on the screen, Taylor, if you can do that.
That would be great. And we're going to be serving breakfast, and also lunch will be furnished by Chick-fil-A. We'll have raffle tickets. We have all kinds of Titan memorabilia that you can see, autographed footballs. Without a doubt, I'm going to have two tickets for the world champion Philadelphia Eagles versus the Titans for you on the 50-yard line. So you may be the lucky one to win a raffle ticket to go to that game.
Wow.
But
give us your lineup of speakers.
That's exciting. I'm excited about that. Bruce Matthews, the captain of the Titans. We went to the Super Bowl, Hall of Fame player. Will be a speaker. We also have Mike McIntyre, whose dad was a famous coach here at Vanderbilt for years. He was coach of the year at Colorado University in 2016.
Right.
Coach Ron Brown, who was at Nebraska 23 years, now at Liberty University. Two Titan players, Ben Jones, the starting center, Ryan Succop, the kicker, who holds the NFL records, and one of my favorites, Chris Sanders, a wide receiver I coached, who has a tremendous faith. And I have to tell you, two of the top people, I'm not sure if I can say it here at Channel 5, but Rudy Kalis is joining us, and Hope Hines is joining us.
Well,
it's going to be a lot of fun.
Well, we were with Les and a lot of other men Saturday morning a few days ago when Rudy and I spoke, along with Jim Bonds. Jim Bonds, by the way, you may remember, who was the sports director for a number of years at Channel 2 here in town, and we spoke and had a great fellowship and a great time. Les, of course, was there, and it was just a great time. And you're so what if a man is sitting out there and he heard what you just said about this event on Saturday, and he's thinking, well, maybe I ought to go. Well, I don't know what's going to go on there. What are they going to try to do? Kind of lay out what your aspirations and hopes are for this Saturday.
Yeah, that's a great question, Hope. I'm glad you asked it. Our whole dream is to get men and young people, young boys age 14 and older, and as many coaches out there. A name that I want to mention is Steve Hagan, who coached in the NFL 11 years, was a very well-known coach at Notre Dame as an assistant, who is helping me put this ministry together, an event. Steve is in charge of the coaches ministry here in FCA. And it's his dream, my dream, and so many others that are helping support this, for men and coaches and young men 14 and older to come and be influenced, which is the theme for FCA for 64 years, and hear about how to live a life of integrity, of discipline, and certainly learn more about the Christian faith. I just mentioned to you that are listening, the tickets are $15. And if you bring a friend or a young person 14 years or older, it comes 2-for-1. Well, and I think, where do you get breakfast and lunch for $15 for two people today?
I don't know.
I think it can be an awful special experience.
Right.
But the purpose is to influence young men, coaches, and dads out there who we really believe would be inspired by these speakers. I know young people and teams would be heavily influenced by what they hear these professional athletes talk about, and so we welcome you again. I just want to say that website one more time is brentwoodbaptist.com/men-training-camp.
Good.
Thanks, Hope.
And for you men sitting out there, don't worry about whether you're a Christian or not. Don't worry about being a Christian. Well, I'm not a Christian, so I can't go to this event, or I can't go to this church. You are the very one that needs to go to this event and this church on Saturday morning.
No question. And I have to tell you, Hope, if they like football,
yep,
and they want to hear football stories,
they're going to do it. Yeah.
They're going to be 4 hours worth of football stories. And I have to tell you, it's we've done this event two other times at the church, and we get 400 or 500 plus men, from what I understand.
Right.
I may be exaggerating about the 500, but we hope to get 500 men this time around.
Les Steckel is our special guest here on this very special occasion on Sportsline. I'm Hope Hines. We will continue right after this timeout.